Have you tried to use xAPI, but you get stuck with the code, especially the JavaScript part of it, and you wish there was an easier way to actually send over custom statements through like Storyline or Captivate? Well, I'm going to show you a tool that will make it a whole lot easier, and most of it is just kind of copying and pasting it into the right areas. So I'm going to go ahead and dive into that next. My name is Jeff Bout at Learning Dojo. If you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out blog posts with previous tips and tricks, as well as templates that you can download for Storyline and xAPI. You can also check out courses on Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, xAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom Scorm, and HTML5 Video. Now, I've posted a lot on xAPI and really what xAPI is, the foundation of the statements, the different parts of the statements as well, like the actor, the verb, and the object as well. So if you wanted to check those out, go back to my blog and check out those videos. But now we're going to talk about a tool that will make it easier to implement xAPI, and I'm talking about xAPI that's outside of a learning record store. Storyline and Captivate will actually publish to an xAPI-enabled learning management system and allow you to upload it there. So I'm not talking about that, but if you wanted to do that, there's also a video on my blog about that as well. I'm talking about actually taking your content and hosting your content somewhere else, not inside of a learning record store, but somewhere else, and then still having that information track over to a learning record store. Now this tool, which is still in beta, but this tool will allow you to actually enable Storyline and Captivate and even custom HTML and track content from anywhere. So I'm going to go to this tool, which is found at xapibuilder.learningdojo.ninja. And this tool, like I mentioned, is just in beta, so go ahead and test it out and let me know if you have any feedback here. But there's really three steps to this tool. There's adjusting your project settings and adding the learning record store information, choosing which tool you're going to be using, and then building out your statements and then downloading and attaching your files. So the first thing I want to do is go into my project settings. In my project settings, this is how I connect to the learning record store. This is how xAPI knows where to send the information, or else it doesn't know where to send the information. There's tons of learning record stores out there, so it needs to be able to connect and authenticate that you're able to send information over. Now, you get this information inside of your learning record store. So depending if you're using like Learning Locker, or you're using Veracity, or if you're using something like Watershed or something like that, you'll need to get this information from there. Now, the one that I like to use for just testing purposes is Scorm Cloud. You can sign up for a free account and you can just test it out and play around with it. I've signed up for a free account at cloud.scorm.com. And then once I'm signed in, I can go to the xAPI LRS. Now I can get the learning record store endpoint here. Now within your learning record store, you can have different endpoints. And so it kind of separates out your data. I'm going to send it over to my Scorm Cloud sandbox here. So this is the learning record store that I need. The endpoint that I need. So I'm going to go ahead and copy that and make sure you don't copy anything with spaces. So I'm going to copy that, come over to my endpoint and just paste it there. Now coming back to my learning record store, I'm going to go ahead and grab the activity provider, which the activity provider you can create over on the right hand side if you don't see anything. But the activity provider is how you authenticate. It's almost like a username and a password without exposing your actual username and password. So this is basically, I'm going to copy that username right there or the key, come over here and then paste it right there. Now, if this is ever compromised, it's easier to turn off that activity provider and disable it so it can't send over information instead of having to change your password and everything. So I'm going to go ahead and copy the secret there and paste the secret there. Now I'm going to choose Storyline, Captivate, or HTML5. You may be thinking, okay, what about other tools like Domino or Lectora or something like that? Well, those tools actually allow you to send over statements outside of a learning record store a whole lot easier than having to do something like this. And so if you're using those tools, just do it within those tools. But Storyline and Captivate really don't have that ability, so that's why this tool comes into play. So I'm going to choose Storyline here. So I'm going to make sure Storyline is there. And you can do the same thing with Captivate. And then I'm going to come in to my statement generator. Now, I've already generated a couple statements, but I'm going to go ahead and delete those. But you can see here, the first thing I want to do is I want to choose the verb. So we're going to identify the actor inside of the learning records or inside of the course itself. We're going to have them enter in their name and their email. You probably want to do that through like a single sign-on, which takes, depending on your single sign-on, could take a little bit of development that way, but it's doable. And then you choose what action. What did they do? And you describe that action with the object. And so I'm going to come in here to the actions, and I know that I want to track when they first launch a page. So I'm going to say initialized, and then just find the initialize and select that. If you wanted to clear search and then search for all the verbs, you can click on those three dots. Or you can click on this little eye icon, this information icon, and it will take you to the whole list of ADL verbs that you can look through and see exactly what's out there. Either way works here. So I'm going to come back in here and just start typing in initialized again. I'm going to select that verb, and you can see the statement that shows up on the bottom. It doesn't have all the information that we need it to because we want to describe what did they initialize. And that's what I do over here by the title and then the description. The title, you want to keep it as short as possible. If I come back into my learning record store and go into the LRS viewer here and then select my sandbox, you'll notice that most of my statements just have like a simple statement or description, like the action and then the description. So I want to keep it that simple. And then if you click on it, then you'll see like the overall or the more detailed description. So that's why you want to keep it simple there. All right, so what did they initialize? We're going to say that they initialized page 2, and then we're going to describe learner engage with page 2. I could probably describe it more if I wanted to, but that's good enough for now. Now I'm going to save this, and I can start building my other statements. So I'm going to hit save, and then I'm also going to say interacted. So I'm going to find interacted. The learner interacted with something here. And what did they interact with? Well, I'm going to say the page 2 button. And there we go. Now I'm going to go into the description. Learner clicked on page 2. One of the nice things that I like about xAPI is you can track a whole lot more with xAPI. You can track exactly what they've clicked on, what pages they visited, if they downloaded the PDF or anything like that. So it just opens up a lot more possibilities. So you can see how effective your courses are. Completion doesn't really tell you if they really engaged with it or if they've actually, you know, the knowledge transfer there happened or anything like that. So this gives you a lot more information. So I'm going to hit save there. And then we have these two different statements. So I'm going to copy these statements and paste them inside of Storyline. So let's do the first thing, initialize. Let's hit copy here. So I'm coming into Storyline and I'm on page 2 right now. So I'm going to execute JavaScript, and I already have that action selected. So I can just hit the JavaScript window here, paste that there. This is going to run when the timeline starts, which is exactly what I want. I want this to trigger as soon as the page loads. And then I want something to trigger when they click on this button. So I'm going to come over to triggers here and then execute JavaScript. And we're going to copy this other button here and just paste in our code there. And there we go. I'm going to click OK there. And we have those two JavaScript files. Now, in order for this to work, I need to go to my last section here. I need to download the files and I need to attach the files to my published project. But in order for that to work, I actually need to have three different variables inside of Storyline. So I'm going to come into my variables section, and I already have email address and I already have username. And in fact, on page 1, I'm having them enter in their name and I'm having them enter in their email address. And that's what I'm using for the actor. They enter in their name and their email address, and then it will store that inside of a variable. Now, you could actually create or grab the information from a single sign-on and store that information inside of a variable so the user doesn't actually have to enter anything here. That may be a step that you eventually want to get to, but you can at least test things out for now. But we're missing one variable. We also need to define this object, this activity, this learning activity with an ID, a unique ID. This allows us to then filter and create reports inside of a learning record store. So this is an important part here. And make sure that you also create your variables with the same name, the capital A right here, and then the capital N. So I'm going to create a new variable, and this is going to be object ID with the capital ID there. So now here I'm going to grab my website. So coming back over to learningdojo.ninja, I'm going to grab my website minus the blog part, and I'm going to use that as the unique ID because nobody else has this website. This is my website. So that's usually why you want to create your own or grab your own website, your organization website. And then just to define it, this doesn't have to be a real URL. Somebody can't really go to this. But just to define it as xAPI, I usually type in xAPI and then slash, and then I'm going to go ahead and say this one is about harassment. So I'm going to say 01 and then underscore harassment. And again, it doesn't have to be an existing learning records or an existing URL or anything like that. I'm just going to click OK. And then I'm going to click OK there. Now I'm going to double check to make sure that has saved. But yes, it has saved. So we're ready to go. Now I can just go ahead and publish this out. Now I don't need to publish to a learning management system because this is going to really track it from anywhere. So I'm going to go ahead and just do it to the web here. And it's going to publish to my desktop and then go ahead and hit publish. Now I'm using Mac with Parallels. So I'm going to switch back over to my Mac here. And you can see we have our files. I need to place a couple different files inside of here. This is where we kind of attach the code that we've built, attach it to Storyline and make sure that it works here. So I'm going to come back into here and I'm going to download these three different files. And I'm going to take those three different files and I'm going to paste them inside or just move them inside of the story underscore content here. Now, this is the file that runs. When you first launch your course, this is the HTML file that will run, and then it will pull everything else in. But I need to let this file know that those other files are there, and you do that by attaching. So I'm going to come into Visual Studio Code. You can download this for free. And I'm going to go ahead and open this folder up. If I just opened up Visual Studio Code, I can just drag the folder in there. But inside of here, we need to go into the story HTML file and just scroll all the way down to the bottom there. Now, before this HTML tag, this closing tag, I need to bring it down a couple lines and I need to attach those three files. And essentially, we're just letting this Storyline course know that those three files exist in order for the code to run. So I'm going to go ahead and just type in script. And you can see in Visual Studio Code, it actually gives you hints. And I'm going to select the one with the SRC standing for source. And then I'm going to go ahead and start typing in the name of the folder where these files are. And then the first file that I want to attach is the crypto.js. So that's the first one. Then I do the same thing here. So I'm going to do story underscore content. And we're going to attach the xAPI wrapper second. And now the last one is the Learning Dojo code, which is the story underscore content and then LDXAPI. So I'm going to go ahead and attach that. Now, if you wanted to make your life a little bit easier, you could actually just copy those three files and then you can just save them in a note somewhere and just paste those every time you hit publish. But that's all that you actually need to do. Hit save and let's go ahead and preview this now. So I'm going to go back into this folder and double click on story.html. Now I'm going to type in my name, Sammy McGee, and I'm going to go ahead and type in an email. Sammy McGee is just a name I use all the time. I don't know why. I just like the name. So I'm going to go ahead and click on next, and then I'm going to click on run code. If I come back into my learning record store, if everything has been connected right, I can hit refresh, and you can see right there, there are my two statements. So it says Sammy McGee interacted with page two button, or Sammy McGee initialized page two. So if I click on that and expand it out, this is where I have that description. So it gives a little bit more details here. So I didn't need to type any code. I didn't need to, besides the script, the attachments, but you can copy and paste that. And in fact, I may just even place those where you can just copy and paste it right here eventually. But you didn't need to do that. You could go in here, you can just add the lines of code back into my xAPI builder You could just copy these lines of code to trigger the different statements, and now you can get a lot more information. And if you're using a learning record store like Watershed or Learning Locker or something like that, you can start to create dashboards and connect data and see, you know, what are the most pages viewed in your course. So a lot of possibilities. And this is just the start for this xAPI builder, but hopefully it's useful for you, and hopefully you can actually take advantage of this and use it. And let me know if you have any other feedback. If you want to check out other courses or other blogs about xAPI or augmented reality or Storyline or Captivate, you can go ahead and come back to learningdojo.ninja. But that's all that I had for you. So if you, again, have any other questions, just let me know. Thanks, everyone.